Hi, it's Peter here. To win more badminton doubles games, you need certain tactics in place. You need a strategy. Not that long ago, I asked the question, when do I need to rotate in badminton doubles? This is a difficult question to answer, as it depends on how you and your partner play together. However, the information in this video should remove any stumbling blocks. In this video, I will be just looking at level doubles. I will look at what rotation is, what mistakes some players make when rotating, and when to rotate. Rotation is specifically used in badminton doubles when a pair are attacking. It can be used when a player is covering for their partner when they believe they're out of position, when one of the players is becoming fatigued, when they believe they can hit a winning shot, or when they believe that they'll get a tactical advantage from it. One mistake a lot of players make is that they play sides. A badminton doubles pair should play a front and back formation and then rotate when necessary. Nevertheless, a lot of players play sides where they take one side of the court, which leaves massive gaps in their attacking play. Another common mistake players make is they try to cover too much of the court. This can confuse their partner and make it uncertain of whose shot is whose. In the first scenario, a pair are on the attack. The rear court player plays a straight smash from the side tram lines. The defending player plays a cross court lift. As the rear court player will struggle to get to that shot, the front court player should cover for him or her and play a shot. In the second scenario, the rear court player plays an overhead attacking shot cross court to the defending player opposite him. The defending player plays an attacking lift to the opposite side of the court. The front court player should cover this area of the court for his or her partner. In this scenario, the rear court player plays a straight attacking shot. One of the defending players plays a non-threatening cross court shot to the other half of the court. The rear court player is quick to get to the other side and plays another straight attacking shot. One of the defending players then plays another cross-court lift to the other side of the court. As the rear court player will struggle to change direction, the front court player should cover for his or her partner. In the final scenario, the rear court player is stood towards more of the middle of the court. He or she plays a straight attacking shot. As the rear court player is stood towards the middle of the court, he or she should start signalling to the front court player that he or she is moving forwards, and the front court player then can then go backwards. They should therefore rotate their positions, with one player going to the front of the court and the other player going towards the back of the court. Thanks for watching this video. In summary, use this video as guidance for level doubles rotation. However, you do not need to follow it to the letter. Other factors will come into play, such as your partner's strengths and weaknesses. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Make sure you like and subscribe.